guys, it's Erica Galinas with the Mike McCaddy team at Century 21 affiliated in Schererville. I'm here for our monthly St. John Market update. Pretty straightforward, just September. It's our my last one went through the end of September, so we're doing October this month. Not a lot of changes. There's some the prices went down a little bit. Obviously, the big story is new construction, but we'll kind of go through that as we go through the numbers. So, in the month of October, so from the 1st to Halloween, we sold 24 units of real estate in St. John. Again, that includes the cheapest condo in town or the most expensive estate. An average sale price of $344,000. Average days on market, 106 days on market. That's kind of a higher number for the market we have now compared to other towns. Part of the reason, I'm sure, is because a lot of this is new construction. So, you know, they sit on the market a little bit longer because they're, you know, the builder will list a house, but it's just a plot of land. So they list it way, way back in the beginning. And then as buyers come to open houses or see, you know, online ads or talk to their agent, come up in searches. So they tend to stay in the market a little bit longer. It doesn't really indicate that the market is any slower. It's really just that new construction. So our average sales price was $344,000 in the month of October. That's actually a drop of about $22,000 over our September average sales price, which is $366,000. That's kind of a big drop in our market right now. I did a little research into why that might be, and what it looks like is you figure it takes four to six months to close on a new construction home. So I think what may have happened is that in September, if we count back 3-4 months, these people were going under contract in May and June. Over the summer, the builder built all those houses, so they closed in September. And obviously, the newer construction homes are going to have higher sales prices. It's just the way the market is. So that change right there, that $22,000, is a little bit higher than some of the average prices in other towns. But just the same as the average days on market, I think it's due to that new construction influence. So for existing home sales, you're in real good shape. So of those 24, 10 were new construction homes, so almost 50%. Most of the new construction that closed was in the high 300s. There was some $400,000 ones, but there were some older existing homes that were in the $400,000 range. So these higher prices in St. John are benefiting not just the new construction stuff, but existing owners as well. So that's actually really good news if you're thinking of selling. So as of today, there are 54 pending listings in St. John. Pending means that they have an accepted offer, but they haven't closed yet. And it could be because, just regular, they're waiting for the appraisal and home inspections, or it could be because these builders are building these houses and they are not going to close for several more months. So, like I said, 54 pending. The average price of these pending homes is $343,000, which is good. That's right on target. Nice stable number. 55 days on market. So that dropped as well. So it could be because homes are just selling a little faster. It could be because new construction, they put up what they call spec homes, so they're ready to go, ready to move into, or ones that they started building and finished more quickly because of summertime or other reasons. But that puts us a little bit faster, which is good news. The new construction, there's 20 new constructions out of those 54, so not quite 50%, but getting close, maybe whatever the math would be, 35-40% of that is new construction. And then in terms of our active listings, so what's currently for sale in St. John, there's 103 active listings. It's about 64, almost exactly 60-40 actually. So of that 103, 61 are existing homes, so anything that's already been built, and 42 are brand new construction, which is, that's a lot of new construction, particularly for a town the size of St. John. As we know, most of these places are going into the gates. They have all kinds of things in the gates. The lowest price new construction is $279,000, which is a townhome unit. I believe, I think it's in the gates, probably. And then the highest one on there right now is $434,000. Now, obviously, when new construction closes, those numbers may go up. The $434,000 is probably a base model price for new construction, but then somebody, a buyer wants to put in fancy countertops, or they want to add on an extra garage, or, all the different things that you customize when you build a home. That may end up, when these sell and close, that may end up being higher. So Gates of St. John, obviously there's tons of construction. There's also quite a bit back in Walden, Wingate. There's some in Dancing Waters. So new construction in St. John is still quite robust as compared to some of the surrounding towns. I don't know if you watch my Dyer update, Schererville update, you know, there's not a lot of new construction going on anywhere else because there's no land left. So what these developers are doing now is filling in that big empty piece of land from, say, 93rd down to the town line of Cedar Lake. And in Cedar Lake, the developers are filling a lot of that area up, too. It's predominantly on the 41 side of Lake County, A, because there's more land there, and B, because they are pulling in those Illinois buyers, and 41 is, you know, what, 5-10 minutes tops from the state line. That we talked about this a little bit last time. St. John is going through big change right now. Like I said, the lowest that they are offering for sale is $279,000. So none of the stuff that's being built in St. John would be considered, say, affordable housing. Obviously, lots of people can afford $279,000, but that does cut off a significant chunk of real estate buyers. There are good things and bad things that go along with that, and it's up to you to decide how you feel. But as St. John grows in the future, it certainly appears to be growing towards a more executive-level community. I don't know if that's exactly the word I want, but just basically fancier houses versus, you know, condo associations or, you know, just smaller three-bedroom, 1,500-square-foot new homes. They're building big, fancy houses. Again, good or bad, depending on how you feel, but it's going to bring more traffic. Also, it's going to bring more shopping and restaurants and things like that. So overall, I think it's a positive thing for St. John, but, you know, as I always say, keep involved in the community because the changes that are going on right now they're going to affect everybody forever, pretty much. But overall, the market looks good. Sellers of existing homes, your prices are going to be a little bit depressed because that new construction pressure, they're always going to sell for more, and existing homes are always going to sell for less when there's new construction to be had. And you guys got a ton of new construction competition, but your stuff is still selling, and it's actually selling at a very good price. You know, historically, over the average over the past, say, 5 years, St. John is doing real well. So if you are thinking of relocating from St. John, I'm happy to help you. I've sold property there before. Give me a call. Text me anytime, 219-765-2062. You can always comment on these videos down below. I check those out all the time. You can send me a direct message through Facebook. YouTube, I think, has messaging capability. You can also always send me an email at hsbyerica. That stands for Home Sales by Erica, E-R-I-C-A, at gmail.com. We're going to keep an eye on the St. John market over the next, say, 6 to 12 months. There's been a lot of talk about recessions, particularly in the luxury market, which would kind of focus on St. John, but we have such an interesting influence, very unique nationwide, because we have these Illinois buyers that are coming over here for lots of reasons. It's going to be interesting to see what's going to happen with all this new construction. If we get into a situation where it's not selling, you know, that benefits existing homeowners because they can sell still. They don't have to wait around for this new construction at these premium prices. But it may end up, you know, selling like hotcakes. You know, there people who are relocating from Illinois are relocating because they're budget conscious. But because we have such tax advantages, it's almost a wash. So even if they're spending more on a luxury home, they almost always are spending less in terms of, you know, the total taxes and insurance and everything else in their mortgage payments. So we're going to keep an eye on this. I'm interested to see what's going to happen because St. John is going to be a lot different town than it was when I lived there in 1998-99. So thanks a lot. If you, like I said, if you have any questions about St. John real estate or buying a house or anything like that, I'm certainly happy to help. Give me a call or text me anytime. And you guys have a good Thanksgiving. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.